We do greet you in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Most High God. We do thank God now for all of you that are tuned in around the world. We thank God for God giving you a mind tonight to tune into the program. We are here tonight to do as we often do, and that is to get into the Word of God. We are experiencing some pretty rough weather here in Mobile, Alabama, so hopefully everything will go well with the streaming on tonight. We have a skeleton crew in the house tonight. We had everyone to stay home due to the weather, so we just got some out that I call the essential workers tonight, those that here to assist to make sure the broadcast still goes out. So y'all keep us in your prayers. Keep us in your prayers. We've had tornadoes and severe thunderstorms pretty much all day. We ask all the saints of God who's at home watching, y'all be safe. And if any of you need any assistance with anything, certainly reach out to us and just let us know. All right, just a reminder, we want to remind the saints in the New York and surrounding areas, Lord willing, we're coming your way. We will be coming to Tarrytown, New York. That's April 20th and April 21st. We'll be in Tarrytown, New York, April 20th and April 21st. We'll be at the Sheraton Tarrytown Hotel, located at 600 White Plains Road, Tarrytown, New York. Saturday service, 6 p.m., Sunday service, 11 a.m. Again, Saturday service, 6 p.m., and Sunday service, 11 a.m. Tarrytown, we're looking to have a good time with you all once we get there. Saints from Connecticut, New Jersey, New York, Virginia. We're looking for all of you all to meet us there on April 20th and 21st. Afterward, May 25th and 26th, we will be in Dallas, Texas. Go to our website, sonofgodlives.org. Click on the events page to see the itinerary. Following that, June 15th and 16th, we'll be in Columbia, South Carolina. Columbia, South Carolina. Again, go to our website to see the itinerary. July 6th and 7th, we will be in Montgomery, Alabama. July 6th and 7th, we will be in Montgomery, Alabama. July 27th and 28th, we'll be in Chicago, Illinois. Again, July 27th and 28th, Chicago, Illinois. August 17th and 18th, Houston, Texas. And again, go to our website, sonofgodlives.org. Click on the events page to see our itinerary for the rest of the year. Saints of God, we thank God for all of you now that again tune in around the world. We're so glad that you tune into the program here tonight. Tonight, I just want to take a moment before we get into the word. I want to thank God for the Menendez family. I want to sincerely thank God for the Menendez family out of Florida. They traveled here on this past weekend. They heard the broadcast. And had been listening to the program, and the Lord opened their understanding, and they traveled here last weekend from Florida and was baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, the entire family. We thank God for them. I did receive a text from them once they arrived back to Florida, and I want to read it. They write, "We just made it home to our house in Florida. Thank you again for everything today. Everyone was so kind and welcoming, and the food was delicious. Hope to see you all again soon. God bless you all. Samantha Mendez and family." Sister Mendez and family, we thank God for you all. It was a pleasure to get a chance to meet you all. More than anything, I thank God for opening y'all's understanding to the Word of God. I sincerely thank God for that. This family was following First Church. He was following First Church, and the brother, he testified to me how he had never heard of us. He had never heard of Elder Murray, never listened to us. But some of the things that Gino started to say against Jesus, the way he would talk about Jesus, Brother Mendez told me he knew something was wrong. It didn't sit well with him. And how he started trying to show different ones that, hey, Gino is saying this, but the Bible says this. And how, of course, it fell on a deaf ear. They didn't want to listen. And his spirit just was not at ease with a lot that was being said concerning Jesus Christ. Brother told me how the Lord blessed him to be able to catch our program. It was not by coincidence. I truly believe it was divinely inspired of God. He caught our program, and when he caught our program, he told me, he said, "That's it. That's what I've been talking about right there. That's what I've been trying to tell others right there. That's it." So I thank God how the Lord allowed him to catch the program. God did not harden his heart. The Lord had already opened his understanding. The word of God that we was preaching here bear witness with his spirit. He got his entire family out of there, and they all came here on this last past Sunday and was baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank God for how the Lord is truly drawing his people together. So to the Mendez family, we thank God for you all. And likewise, we hope to be able to see you all again soon. Tonight, brothers and sisters, I've got quite a bit of calls. I got quite a bit of calls that we're going to take. But before we get into the calls, I want to also make mention, some of you have asked about Zelle. Asked if the church had Zelle whereby they could pay donations or tithe or offering through and by Zelle. Well, we have Zelle now. We do have Zelle now. You're able to pay now through and by Zelle. The username is eldermurray@att.net. That is the username. That is actually my email address, but is also the username for Zelle. eldermurray@att.net. That money goes to the church. It don't go to Elder Murray. That's just simply the username. This information also can be found on our website. If you go to the donation link, you'll see the username for Zelle along with Cash App and others. All right? So we do have Zelle now. We thank God for all of your support. All right. Tonight, brothers and sisters, we got, again, quite a bit of calls that we're going to try to take as long as time will allow. And then I do have some messages here from overseas that we're going to try to take. We're going to try to take some of the overseas callers and messengers tonight as well. Twin, if you would, give me caller number one. Caller number one, once you get it, let it out.
Good afternoon. Got some Murray. My name is Sister Jackson. I've been listening at your, watching your program for about 3 years now, and I have always enjoyed it, and I see that a lot of times you get a lot of negative feedback, but I just wanted you to know what you are doing. I appreciate it so much. Your message from the Bible has helped my life out a lot, and I just want you to know that I appreciate it, and I hope everybody can understand you and get the same message that I get and that I read for myself, and you describe it for me, and I love the way you do it, and I love the way you lead the message, and I just want you to know that I am one that receives it, because I do read the Bible for myself, and I love the way you explain it. So simple. It's so easy to understand the way you relieve your message, and I just want to thank you so much. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Go ahead and play caller number two as well, Twin.
Elder Murray, this is Sister Jackson again. I would also like to thank your son and your son-in-law because you all start my day off before I go to church when I get there. And I am already, y'all already helped me to get filled with the Holy Spirit. And I just want to thank you again. Have a good day. Bye-bye.
Sister Jackson, we appreciate your encouragement. We appreciate you more than you know. Your call is a breath of fresh air. Trust me, it's a breath of fresh air based on some of the others that we receive. And I may even let y'all hear some of them tonight. But callers like this, it is a very encouraging when we're able to hear and see how the Word of God is affecting God's people, how it is encouraging God's people, how it's uplifting God's people, how it's opening the eyes of God's people. Very encouraging. Thank God for you, Sister Jackson. Caller number three. Caller number three. Once you get it, let it air.
Praise the Lord, Pastor Murray.
I was calling because I know you said you was moving to the Word Network. Are you still going to be on YouTube? Because I don't have the Word Network. I just got regular. I watch you off of YouTube. So I don't even know what channel. I know you named a different channel. But I'm trying to see. We have cable, but we don't have the... we have Firestick. We don't have the Word Network, so I still want to be able to listen to your sermons. So, like I said, I watch you off of YouTube. So I wonder, will you still be on YouTube as well? So that's all I wanted to know. I just didn't want to miss your messages. Thank you. Have a great day.
Caller, we appreciate your call. Sincerely thank God for you. And by all means, we will remain on YouTube. We're not coming off YouTube. The only way we come off YouTube, they kick us off. Otherwise than that, we still will be on YouTube as well. We actually started the Word Network on last Friday. Last Friday night, we started on the Word Network. Friday nights at 11 p.m. Eastern Time, 10 p.m. Central Time, and 8 p.m. Pacific Time. All right, so the Word of God will be going forth on the Word Network, just like it's going forth on the Impact Network, and so many other stations that we're on. You can go to our website and click on the media page there, and you'll be able to see all the different television stations around the world that we're on. But we will remain on YouTube as well, all right? All right. All right, now y'all listen. I'm gonna air this call, caller number four. This is an anonymous call from First Church. I want y'all to listen very carefully to what he is saying. He's going to disguise his voice, and he's going to tell you he's disguising his voice. But I want y'all to hear the sincereness in this brother, but also the fear that's in him. All right? Caller number four, twin. Caller number four. Let it air.
Hello, sir. I just want to say something to you. There's a lot of us over here at the church. You know the church I'm talking about. Gino. There's a lot of us over here. We listen to you. We believe in you. But he knows our family. Right now, I am disguising my voice. And I'm quite sure you know that. But, you know, what I want to say is keep up the good work. We believe in you. One day we'll join you. You know, it seems like really like you're stuck. We talk about it because sometimes I'm believing you know me, but there's a lot going on here. Sir, you're preaching the word. You believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I mean, you sit back and say, how could we not? You make it as plain as a baby can understand. Just plain stuff. God bless you. I thank God for you. Thank you, Lord. You have a blessed day. The team that you have coming, sir, the Bible says, eyes are not seen, ears are not heard, or something like that, what the Lord has in store. But I don't think you even see what God has in store for you. This day. You know, it's just an ant compared to what the Lord has been. God bless you, sir.
Let me say to the brother, I appreciate your call. I appreciate your sincere call. You that perhaps didn't quite understand what he was saying, he's an anonymous caller. He's from First Church. He mentioned that there's a lot of them listening to us, listening to the broadcast, and how they have talked among themselves, how they are stuck, how they're stuck. He said that, you know, they believe in us and what we're preaching. And he said one day, he didn't finish his statement, but he said one day, well, brother, I hope that day comes sooner rather than later. I hope and pray the Lord deliver y'all out of there sooner rather than later, my brother. That's my sincere prayer for you all. I hear your sincereness, but I also hear your fear. I hear that as well, my brother. And brother, I want you to know this. There's no reason to fear a man. Amen. There's no reason for you to have to call and disguise your voice. I want you to understand something, my brother. I discern your sincereness, but I also discern your fear. The spirit that has you afraid, the spirit that has you in fear is not the spirit of God.
Amen.
Brother, it is the spirit of witchcraft. It is the spirit of sorcery that got y'all so terrified of a man that you as a man got to disguise your voice. That's not the liberty that's in Christ Jesus, brother.
Amen.
Not at all. 2 Timothy, let's help this brother, Bracy. 2 Timothy chapter 1, son, and start at verse number 7. 2 Timothy 1, 7. Brother, I want you to listen carefully to Ella Murray tonight. Because I want to help you, brother. I want to help you and all the rest of them over there that's listening. 2 Timothy 1, 7 said what?
For God hath not given us the spirit of fear.
Hey, brother, if you got the spirit of fear, you didn't get it from God.
Amen.
God ain't gave you that kind of spirit, brother, where you afraid of a man. You've got to disguise your voice. Brother, God ain't gave you that spirit. You done took on another spirit. You're sitting under a spirit of witchcraft. That is what witchcraft is. It's a form of control. Puts fear in you to control you, to keep you in check, to keep you in bondage, to keep you under that man's control. That's what you're under, brother. That's liberty in Christ Jesus. Man, I ain't got to disguise my voice to call nobody.
Amen.
What did it say, Brayson?
For God has not given us the spirit of fear.
God ain't gave us the spirit of fear.
But of power.
What did he give us?
Of power.
He gave us power.
And of love.
And of love.
And of a sound mind.
Man, I got the power of God. I love everybody. And I got a sound mind.
Amen.
Do you understand? I got the power of God. I got love. And I've got a sound mind.
Amen.
Read it, Brayson.
Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord.
Do you hear what he's saying, brother? Paul here is saying, okay, God ain't gave you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Now he's saying, don't you be afraid of what, Brayson?
Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord.
Don't be ashamed of the testimony of the Lord, brother. The Lord will open your understanding.
Amen.
Your eyes are open. You don't. Paul said, don't be ashamed of that.
Amen.
Open your mouth wide and let them know, I see what the word of God is saying.
Amen.
I see God got a son at his right hand that's in the heavens that's coming back at the end. Don't be ashamed of it, brother.
Amen.
The Lord will own your understanding for a reason. My God, God ain't gave you the spirit of fear. Read it again, Brayson. What did he say?
For God hath not given us a spirit of fear.
God ain't gave you the spirit of fear.
But of power and of love and of a sound mind.
Love, sound mind. What else did he say?
Be not thou therefore ashamed of the testimony of our Lord.
Man, the Lord will own your understanding. Don't be ashamed. Because, brother, if you be ashamed of him, he's going to be ashamed of you.
Amen.
What did he say, Brayson?
Nor of me his prisoner.
Do you hear what Paul said? Paul said, don't be ashamed of the Lord. Paul said, and don't be ashamed of me, his prisoner. Listen, don't be ashamed, brother, of the Lord. And don't be ashamed to let them know, I believe what the Church of the Lord Jesus Christ in Mobile, Alabama is preaching.
Amen.
It is the word of God. Don't be ashamed of the Lord and don't be ashamed of us. Because we're preaching the Lord.
Amen.
Whatever you have to go through, then we're going to go through it together.
That's right.
And Paul going to let us, he's going to let you know that. Whatever you have to go through for taking a stand for Jesus Christ, brother, count it joy when you go through it.
Amen.
My God, don't be ashamed, Paul said, of the testimony of the Lord, nor of me, Paul said, his prisoner. Read it, son.
But be thou partaker of the afflictions of the gospel.
Be partakers, brother, of the afflictions of the gospel. Whatever you have to go through, whatever they put you through, lift your head and count it all joy, brother.
Amen.
Rejoice whatever they put you through for acknowledging the truth. Let them know I believe the word of God. My God, man, that's coming from that church down in Mobile, Alabama. Said, I believe it, it's chapter, it's verse, and all we can say to it is amen.
Amen.
My God, man, what they gonna do, put you out? What they gonna do, brother, put you out? Well, the day they put you out, by, give me Luke 6:22, son. Let me show you when they put you out. I'm gonna show you how to when you exit the door, I'm gonna show you what I want you to do, bro. Luke chapter 6, brace it at verse 22. What did it say, son?
Blessed are ye.
Blessed are ye.
When men shall hate you.
Brother, when they hate you, it's a blessing. What else, brace it?
And when they shall separate you from their company.
Separate you from their company.
And shall reproach you.
Look, separate you from their company. They don't want you around no more. Read it, brace it.
And shall reproach you.
And shall reproach you.
And cast out your name as evil for the Son of Man's sake.
Why did they do it?
For the Son of Man's sake.
All because you're testifying of the Son of Man. You could see who the Son of Man is now. My God, the Bible said, for the Son of Man's sake. What else?
Rejoice ye in that day.
Hang your head.
Rejoice ye.
The Bible said, rejoice, brother. And do what, Brayson?
And leap for joy.
Did it say leap for joy?
Leap for joy.
When they tell you, get out, you disfellowship.
Leap for joy.
Hallelujah to God. Leap, my brother. Leap for joy. Thank God that you've been counted worthy to suffer for the Lord Jesus Christ's sake.
Amen.
Man, leap for joy.
For behold, your reward is great in heaven.
Is that what it said?
Your reward is great in heaven.
God ain't gave you the spirit of fear, my brother. God ain't gave you the spirit of fear.
Amen.
Leap for joy, my brother. Leap for joy, my God, man, if they disfellowship you and tell you they don't want you around no more. Hallelujah to God. Give me Matthew, son, 10:28. I want to help this brother here. My God, man, you're under a spirit of fear, brother, and God didn't give you that. If God didn't give it to you, who gave it to you?
Amen.
Think about it. If God ain't gave us a spirit of fear, why are you afraid? Who gave you that spirit? Who put that spirit upon you, brother? Who got you afraid, my God, man, when you can't talk with your own voice? Hear me talking now. Matthew 10:28 said what?
And fear not them which kill the body.
Is that what he said?
Amen.
Don't be afraid of them.
Amen.
Fear not them that do what?
Which kill the body.
Don't be afraid of a man. Only thing a man can do is kill your body. Only if God allow that.
Amen.
Read it, Brace it.
But are not able to kill the soul.
But he ain't able to touch your soul.
But rather fear him which is able to destroy both soul and body in hell.
Oh, that's the one we need to fear?
Amen.
Fear the one that's able to destroy body and soul in hell. That's the Lord Jesus Christ, brother. That's who we fear, not a man.
Amen.
Read it, Brace.
Are not two sparrows sold for a farthing?
I want you to hear the example. Are not two sparrows sold for what?
For a farthing.
For a farthing. So two sparrows are sold for a certain amount. Read it.
And one of them shall not fall on the ground without your father.
Do you hear what the Bible is saying? Even the sparrow can't fall to the ground without God's permission.
Amen.
What is the Bible saying? Brother, can't nothing happen to you without God's permission? Can't nothing happen without God's permission? Why are you afraid of a man? Listen, God got everything under control.
That's right.
Look, the man that you're afraid of, let me tell you something, God got him under control.
Amen.
Do you understand? My God, man, a sparrow can't fall to the ground without God's permission. Amen. Read it, Brace.
But the very hairs of your head are all numbered.
Do you know God, my God, know how many strings of hair you got in your head? The very hairs of your head is numbered, brother. Read it, son.
Fear ye not, therefore.
Is that what he said?
Fear ye not, therefore.
Brother, God, look, you standing for righteousness and you got to be afraid? God got you, brother. You take a stand for righteousness, God got you.
Amen.
Read it, Brace.
Ye are of more value than many sparrows.
Hallelujah to God. You're more valuable than many sparrows. There's no reason for you to be afraid. What did it say, Brace?
Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men.
Now, brother. after telling you not to be afraid of man, now he's telling you what you need to do before man. What did he say?
Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men.
Confess the Lord Jesus Christ before man. Brother, let them all know where you stand.
Amen.
Let them know, I believe the Lord Jesus Christ is the Son of God.
That's right.
Let them know that the Lord Jesus Christ can't be the Father. He's the Son of the Father, just like 2nd Epistle of John, verse 3, have said, he's the Son of the Father.
Amen.
Let them know I read it and I believe it. Read it, son.
Whosoever therefore shall confess me before men.
Confess him, brother, right before men. What did he say?
Him will I confess also before my Father which is in heaven.
Is that what he said?
Amen.
So if you confess him, brother, the Lord Jesus is saying he'll confess you.
Amen.
You confess him, he'll confess you. But what if you deny him? What did he say?
But whosoever shall deny me before men.
Oh, my brother, but if you deny him before men, what he gonna do?
Him will I also deny before my Father which is in heaven.
And brother, let me tell you something. Silence equals denial.
That's right.
When you know better, you can see better, the Lord wants a confession from your mouth.
Amen.
He wants you to open your mouth, make a confession. Silence is denial. When the Lord open your understanding, open your mouth and let the world know where you stand.
Amen.
Suffer the consequences. My God, man, Paul said, be partakers of this affliction.
That's right.
Hear me talking now. So, brother, you know better, you see better, open your mouth and let the people know you know better.
Amen.
My God, whatever you have to go through, count it all joy. Count it all joy. Hear me talking. My God, man, you got to get like Ella Murray, my brother, when you don't care.
Amen.
Until you get to that point where you don't care, you can't truly serve God, brother.
That's right.
Because let me tell you something. Something got you under control. Look here. You can't freely serve God because you in fear. Mm-hmm. You got to get to a point, brother, where you don't care.
Amen.
Do you understand? Hey, brother, what they going to do? Run their mouth about you? Lie on you? Slander you? Call you the child of the devil? Well, hey, bro, Murray been called all that. Jesus. Look here. They called Jesus the devil, bro. Murray been called all of that. You doubt what I'm saying? Listen to this. Twin, what I want you to do, I want you to play caller 5, 6, 7, and 8 together. Caller 5, 6, 7, and 8. Let him talk. Let him talk.
Murray, I've been listening to you and your message and your critique of Pastor Gino Jennings. And I find that you are Satan. You are Lucifer in the flesh. And God is going to stop you one day. He's going to stop you one day because you're doing Satan work. You can deceive a lot, but you're not going to deceive all. So I ask you, get off of Gino Jennings. Get off of Gino Jennings in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is against you. You Lucifer, Satan, pit of hell, Satan, get off of my name. The blood of Jesus is against you, Murray. In Jesus' name, I rebuke you, Satan. Go back to hell. Go back to hell from where you come at. In the name of Jesus. Murray, you are Satan. You are from the pit of hell. You are Lucifer in the flesh. And you are doing Satan work. And one day, God is going to stop you. He's going to stop you on the way. You Lucifer. Get back to hell from whence thou comest. You Lucifer. Lucifer, Satan, devil, you are from the pit of hell. You deceive a lot of people, but how long will you deceive these people, Satan? I rebuke you back to hell from when thou comest. Satan, one day God will stop you. Remember that. God is going to stop you. You Lucifer, demon, deceiver. You Murray, you is a liar. Murray, you are Satan. Murray, you are Lucifer in the flesh. I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. The blood of Jesus is against you. Please, I'm asking you to get off our pastor, beloved Pastor Gino Jennings. He's a prophet, a man of God. Please get off of him. And let, you know, you're going to be sorry. God is going to show you a sign. The demons, Lucifer, Murray, the demons and Lucifer. I pray that the Lord will show you a sign. And the blood is against you now. I plead the blood against you. You demons, you deceiver, Lucifer. Get off the man of God. In Jesus' name, I rebuke you.
All right. That's all he can do. That's all he... Hey, caller, anonymous caller. That's all he can do right there, bro. That's it. That's all. Now, do that add to me or take away from me?
No, sir. Not at all.
It don't mean a thing, bro. Hey, anonymous caller. That's all they can do right there, run their mouth. And let me show you how I feel about it, bro. Let me see your mic, Bryce.
Hakuna Matata. What a wonderful phrase.
This is how I feel about it.
Hakuna Matata. It ain't no passing craze. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's our problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata.
That's how I feel about it, Carl. I could care less. Listen, the word of God is manifesting them, and they're upset about it. Hakuna Matata here, brother. All they can do is call and run their mouth, just like you heard one of the brainwashed followers just do. It don't mean nothing, brother. It don't mean nothing. It's no reason for you to fear. Brother, Hakuna Matata. No worries. Don't worry about what they say. Don't worry about them blackballing you, running your name down, trashing you. Hakuna Matata. Mm-hmm. It means no worries for the rest of your days. It's a problem-free philosophy. Hakuna Matata. You got to get there, my brother. When you get there, you won't be disguising your voice because you will be You have the same mentality that we have. You don't care.
Amen.
You don't care, brother. Do you understand? Take a stand for righteousness, brother, and don't worry about what nobody else has to say. All right? Now, let me say this to you. I'm going to respect you, brother. I see the fear that you're in. But if you need to call me, brother, if you wish to call me, I don't have to air it. If you want to call me privately and talk, you can call my office. You and I can talk. Your name will not be mentioned and the conversation won't be mentioned. I give you my word on that. I talk to people from First Church, brother. I talk to them, okay? From time to time, I don't call them. They reach out to me. Let me tell you something. There's a lot that I could say. There's a lot that I could say, you know, but I'm limited because of confidentiality. You mentioned in your call how it's a lot going on. Brother, it's a whole lot more going on than you even know. Trust me. I know all about it. All right? Don't be afraid, brother, when the Lord opens your eyes to walk out the nonsense.
Amen.
Okay? God ain't gave us the spirit of fear, brother. All right? So feel free to call me, brother, and it will stay between you and I. I'll do all I can to be a help to you. I want to use a couple of mothers for an example. Mother Brewster, many of y'all remember Mother Brewster. She was the mother of First Church out of Atlanta. When Mother Brewster and her son started watching the broadcast, It was her son first. He played the bass over at First Church. The Lord opened his understanding first, but his mother was still there. Mother of First Church in Atlanta. When mother reached out to me, her and I started talking confidentially. Nobody knew about it. You know, her and I talked. It was never mentioned. She was in fear. She had that fear. Yes, she did. She had it for a while. When mother would come to the services and places we would go, mother would sit in the back where the camera couldn't pick her up. And I knew what was going on. That fear was still there. But as that word kept coming forth, mother got strength, she got courage, and she got boldness. Mother told me, I want you to baptize me. She said, and I don't care if you record it and post it. She said, I want them to see it. Well, the Lord done gave her some strength now. Mother done, she didn't, look, she got to the place where Murray was already at, Hakuna Matata. She didn't care. We baptized mother, we posted it, she didn't care. Mother McCoy, another mother, out of Georgia as well, from First Church. Same thing with her. When Mother McCoy came on board, Mother McCoy had listened to us for 2 weeks, and she called my office. Mother McCoy told me these words. She said, I have learned more about Jesus Christ in 2 weeks by listening to your broadcast than all the years I've been at First Church. This is what Mother McCoy told me. And I know they're listening. I know they're watching. They know I'm not telling a lie. She said, I've learned more about Jesus Christ in 2 weeks than all my years of being at First Church. We baptized Mother McCoy. Spirit got on Mother McCoy as she was coming up out the water, and she rejoiced for a long time. Do you understand? So I say that to help you, my brother. There's no reason to be afraid.
Amen.
If the Lord can give these mothers strength and courage and the boldness to walk out that nonsense, then likewise he can do the same for you, brother.
Amen.
All right? Hakuna Matata, don't care what they say, bro. You heard how this brother just laid me out? And let me tell you, look here. He had a field day. I don't care. You know what I want him to do? Keep listening. Just keep listening. You see that kind right there? When the Lord prick his heart, he gonna have a long testimony. He gonna remind y'all of all them calls he made to my office, calling me the devil. But he gonna end up in the pool with the devil, going down in water in the name of Jesus Christ, and he gonna come up rejoicing. Just keep listening. If you got any sinness in you at all, just keep listening, Carl. Keep listening. I'm not concerned about what you say. All right? Caller number 9. Caller number 9. Once you get it, let it out.
Oh, this is Jimmy. Oh, I was calling concerning something. There's something I saw on the internet about a pastor from Africa that says he went to heaven and had tea with God. Is there anywhere in the Bible where God had tea with anybody in the Bible, or is that's what he said? He said he had tea with God. So is there anywhere in the Bible where God had tea with anybody in the Old Testament or in the New Testament? I was just concerned when he said it. I was shocked by that. I read the Bible, but I haven't heard of God having tea with anybody. But he said that he had tea with God. So was there anywhere in the Bible where God had tea with anybody? So is there anywhere can you... Let me touch on it a little bit. Thanks so much, and God bless you.
I'll touch on it, brother. There ain't nothing to touch on. There's nothing to touch on, brother. There's no scripture where nobody had tea with God, brother. Now, there's nothing to touch on for somebody having tea with God. That's just a lie. But now let me touch on you, brother. That scripture's for me to touch on you. You're doing exactly what Paul said not to do. Give me Ephesians, son, 4:14. There's no scriptures to touch on, brother, with nobody having tea with God. A false prophet, brother, will say anything. Mm-hmm. And let me tell you something. I am not surprised at what the false prophet said. I'm surprised y'all believe it.
Amen.
That's what I'm surprised at, brother.
Now listen, I appreciate your call, but brother, you're doing exactly what Paul said not to do. Ephesians 4:14 said what?
That we henceforth be no more children.
Don't be as a child.
Tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine.
You don't be like a child, tossed to and fro and carried about with every wind of doctrine. You are here listening to all these doctrines. It's just like the wind blowing. It's just like the weather in Mobile, Alabama today. It was blowing in all kind of directions. Do you understand? And that's the way these doctrines are, brother. And when you don't know the word of God, they confuse you. Now here you trying to find scripture with somebody in heaven drinking tea with God. Hey, bro, you tossed and driven with all these different doctrines. Read it again, Bracey. What did it say?
That we henceforth be no more children tossed to and fro.
And what?
And carried about with every wind of doctrine.
Read it.
By the sleight of men.
And
cunning craftiness whereby they lie in wait to deceive.
That's all they doing, lying and waiting for an opportunity to deceive somebody. Mm-hmm. That's their job, brother. That's what Satan has hired them and ordained them and sent them to do, to lie and wait for the opportunity to deceive somebody. And y'all come along not knowing the word of God, and you thank God in heaven drinking tea. And here a man from somewhere, he said he went to heaven and drank some tea with God.
Came back.
And think about it. You mean you in heaven with God and coming back here? Man, you know that don't sound right. Bruh, never mind the tea. If I'm in heaven with God, I ain't coming back here.
No, sir.
He in heaven with God drinking tea and gonna come back here and tell y'all about it. No, sir, my brother. Not at all, my brother. Bracey, give me Romans 16:17. Give me Romans 16 and that verse 17. Brother, don't be tossed and driven with all this nonsense. Romans 16:17, Bracey. What did it say, son?
Now I beseech you, brother.
Do what?
Mark them which cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned.
Contrary to the doctrine which you have learned. Paul said, mark them that cause what, Bracey?
Offenses, cause divisions and offenses contrary to the doctrine which you have learned.
And do what with them?
And avoid them.
Listen to them.
Avoid them.
They coming on at 3:00.
Avoid them.
Avoid them why?
For they that are such serve not our Lord Jesus Christ.
So they ain't serving the Lord Jesus Christ?
Amen.
They coming with something different and they ain't serving the Lord Jesus Christ. What are they doing?
But their own belly.
They serving their own belly. And what else, Bracey?
And by good words and fair speeches.
By good words and fair speeches.
Deceive the hearts of the simple.
That's what they do. Good words, fair speeches, deceive the hearts of the simple, those who don't know no better. Avoid them kind of fellas, brother. Avoid them. Anytime a man said he went to heaven, just turn it off. You ain't even got to hear the tea part. You ain't even got to hear drinking tea with God. Just say he went to heaven. Just cut it off.
Amen.
Ain't even got to go no further. That's nonsense. Nobody going to heaven and coming back here. Caller number 10, twin. Caller number 10. Once you get it, let it answer.
Good morning, Pastor Murray. First of all, I want to thank you for your teaching. It is reaching many. I'm calling from Birmingham, Alabama. And I have two questions. One, when Jesus began his earthly ministry, he called the 12 disciples. My question is, were they saved when Jesus called them? If so, would you please give me the chapter and verse on that? And the second question is, if women are to keep silent in the church, what about singing in the choir, ushering, doing the secretary announcements, and also teaching Sunday school? I serve in those capacities, and I'm wondering, am I doing the right thing? I'm not. My pastor does allow me to serve in these capacities. So explain that as well as women, you know, speaking in the church and how far we are supposed to go. Again, thank you so much. Your teaching is reaching many. I'll be listening on your Wednesday Bible study night, April the 10th. Thank you very much.
God bless your mother from Birmingham, Alabama. Lord willing, we will be in Montgomery, Alabama on July 6th and July 7th. July 6th and 7th, we'll be at the Hilton Garden Inn East Chase, right there in Montgomery, Alabama, 7665 East Chase Parkway. Saturday service, 6 p.m., Sunday service, 11 a.m. Mother, hope to get a chance to meet you during that particular time. We have others with us out of Birmingham as well. Hopefully all of you all can come and get a chance to be able to meet one another. But let me answer your question, Mother. Your first question was, when Jesus called the 12, was they saved? The answer is no, they was not saved when he called them. Give me Luke 24 and start at verse 31. Let me show it to you written, chapter and verse. They was not saved when Jesus called them. Luke chapter 24, and we're going to start reading, Bracy, round about verse 31. What did it say?
And their eyes were opened.
Now, Mother, this is those two that was on the road to Emmaus. Jesus joined them, but their eyes was holding where they could not identify who he was. Then Jesus started to break bread, and they was able to identify him. The Bible said in verse 31, what did it say?
And their eyes were opened and they knew him.
Their eyes now came open and they know that's Jesus. Read it, Bracy.
And he vanished out of their sight.
And he vanished out of their sight. Now watch this, read it.
And they said one to another.
What did they say?
Did not our heart burn within us?
Did not our hearts burn within us?
While he talked with us by the way.
While Jesus was talking to us by the way. Read it.
And while he opened to us the scriptures.
Read it, Bracy.
And they rose up the same hour and returned to Jerusalem.
They returned to Jerusalem.
And found the 11 gathered together.
Ho, found who?
The 11.
So now we got the apostles. We got his 11. They found the 11 doing what?
Gathered together.
Read it.
And them that were with them.
Read it, son.
Saying, the Lord is risen indeed.
Read it.
And hath appeared to Simon.
Read it.
And they told what things were done in the way, and how he was known of them in breaking of bread.
Read it, son.
And as they thus spake, Jesus himself stood in the midst of them and said unto them.
What did he say to them?
Peace be unto you.
Read it.
But they were terrified and affrighted and supposed that they had seen a spirit.
Thought they was looking at a spirit.
And he said unto them, why are you troubled?
Why are you troubled?
And why do thoughts arise in your heart?
What did he tell them?
Behold my hands and my feet, that it is I myself.
Jesus telling them to look at his hands and his feet. He said, it is I myself.
Handle me and see, for a spirit hath not flesh and bones as you see me have.
All right, Jesus letting them know, I'm not a spirit. A spirit don't have flesh and bone as you see me have. Now watch this, caller. Drop down to verse 49. What else is Jesus going to tell them? You got the 11 right there. Read it, Bracy.
And behold, I send the promise of my Father upon you.
I send the promise of my Father upon you. For him to tell them I'm going to send it, they ain't got it already.
Amen.
I send the promise of my Father upon you, but what?
But tarry ye in the city of Jerusalem until ye be endued with power from on high.
So go to Jerusalem until you receive the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
So no, Mother, they didn't have it when he called them. He's telling them where to go, and they're going to receive it. Now, he told them to go to Jerusalem and tarry there until you be endued with power from on high. Now, let's go to Jerusalem and see what's going to take place. Acts 1:12, we in Jerusalem. What did it say?
Then returned they unto Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet.
They returned where?
To Jerusalem.
Read it.
From the mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem a Sabbath day's journey.
Read it, son.
And when they were come in, they went up to into an upper up. They went up into an upper room.
They went up into an upper room.
Where abode both Peter and James and John and Andrew, Philip and Thomas.
Oh, ho, ho. Who's all up there, Bracy?
Peter and James and John and Andrew.
Read it.
Philip and Thomas.
Read it.
Bartholomew and Matthew. James, the son of Alphaeus, and Simon Zelotes. And Judas, the brother of James.
Read it.
These all continue with one accord in prayer and supplication.
So you got the apostles, you got the disciples, all they're continuing in what?
With one accord in prayer and supplication with the women.
All right, so you got them all gathered there. Jesus told them to go to Jerusalem and tarry till they be endued with power from on high. Give me Acts 2:1. What happened, Brayson?
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
And
suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing mighty wind.
And what happened?
And it filled all the house where they were sitting.
And what happened to them?
And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as a fire.
And
it sat upon each of them.
And what happened to all of them?
And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost.
How many?
They were all filled with the Holy Ghost.
That's where they got it right there, mother. That's where they got it at right there. So to answer your question, when Jesus called them, was they saved? The answer is no. They asked, look at, they was with the Savior.
Amen.
You understand? My God, but they received the Holy Ghost right there. Do you understand? So your second question, women keeping silent in the church, you're asking what about singing in the choir? What about ushering? What about a secretary making announcements and teaching Sunday school? You say you do all of those things. Let me show you something, Mother. There's nothing wrong with singing in the choir. That's right. Nothing at all wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with ushering. And there's nothing wrong with making an announcement as a secretary. But now, we got to talk about your teaching Sunday school.
Amen.
We got to talk about that one now. Hear me talking now. Ain't nothing wrong with the rest of them. Because when the Bible said keep silent in the church, it wasn't talking about singing. It wasn't talking about ushering. And it wasn't talking about making secretary announcements. Paul gonna make it plain exactly what he's talking about. 1 Corinthians 14:33, Brace. 1 Corinthians 14:33. Paul gonna make it plain exactly what he's talking about. 1 Corinthians 14:33 said what?
For God is not the author of confusion,
but
of peace, as in all churches of the saints.
Read it, Brayson.
Let your women keep silence in the churches.
Let your women do what?
Keep silence in the churches.
All right, silent. But what is he talking about? Keep reading.
For it is not permitted unto them to speak.
To do what?
To speak.
Oh, speak. But what is he talking about speaking concerning what? Read it.
But they are commanded to be under obedience, as also said the law.
Read it.
And if they will learn anything.
Learn? So we're talking about teaching and learning. If they will do what?
If they will learn anything.
Let them do what?
Let them ask their husbands at home.
Read it.
For it is a shame for women to speak in the church.
Speak.
To speak in the church.
Okay, Paul, what are you talking about?
What?
Oh. Now, Paul fixing to make it plain what he's talking about, mother. Paul said, what?
Came the word of God out from you.
Paul talking about the word of God. He said, what? Came the word of God out from you? My God, he's speaking concerning women trying to deliver the word of God. He said, what? Came the word of God out from you? Or
came it unto you only?
Search the scriptures, the word of God, from the standpoint of preaching, teaching never came out from the woman.
Amen.
Not teaching the word of God. Do you understand? Aged women taught the younger sisters about natural life. Mm-hmm. How to be chaste, keep us at home, obedient to their own husbands. Do you understand? Not, honey, turn to the book of Kings.
No,
that ain't given to the woman to do that.
No, sir.
That ain't given to her to do that now. Do you understand? Age woman, it said age woman because you're dealing with a woman of experience. Mm-hmm. That can teach the younger women how to love their husbands, how to love their children, how to be chaste, how to be keepers at home, that the word of God be not blasphemed. That's what the aged mothers can teach. My God, but you don't need the word of God for that.
Amen.
You ain't in the book of Job. You ain't in the book of Corinth. You ain't in the book of Acts breaking down scripture. You telling that young sister, my God, man, how to respect and love her husband. That's what you doing. Hallelujah to God. So, mother, you can sing, you can usher, and you can make secretary announcements. But when you get into teaching Sunday school, you're trying to break down the word of God. You're trying to teach now. Do you understand? And the Bible said, 1 Timothy 2:11, 1 Timothy 2:11. Hear me talking now. Bible said, let the women do what?
Let the woman learn in silence with all subjection.
But?
But I suffered not a woman to teach,
nor
to usurp authority over the man.
You got two statements there. She can't teach, nor can she use up authority over the man. She can't teach, and she ain't got no business trying to use up authority over the man. But to do what, son?
But to be in silence.
Why?
For Adam was first formed, then Eve.
Then Eve.
And Adam was not deceived.
But what?
But the woman being deceived was in the transgression.
This is the word of God. So, mother, I hope you got an understanding. If not, call me back. Lord willing, hope to get a chance to meet you. Lord willing, whenever we come to Montgomery, Alabama. All right, y'all, let me call. We're going to get call 11 in a moment. And now, I ignore a lot of these calls, but I want y'all to hear this one tonight. Now, y'all remember last week I made mention about a false prophet from Pensacola, one of the Pensacola false prophets, how he came to our Sunday school one Sunday morning and asked me did I believe that God can give a revelation that's not in the Bible. And I told him no, because the only way we can certify it is by what's written. Well, he heard me mention that last week, so he called my office. Caller number 11. Now, I want y'all to hear the voice of a false prophet. We call him the Pensacola prophet, but he called himself the Pensacola prophet, but he leave off the false. He's a Pensacola false prophet. Listen to caller number 11. Listen to this, y'all.
Greetings, Pastor Murray. Grace and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. This is the prophet from Pensacola. I was calling about what I heard you speak of me Wednesday night. And I was calling to let you know, yeah, you're right, I did say that. And I want to give you a prime example of what I was talking about. This logos or symbol that you have on your videos, that represents the sun god. You don't know that because that's not in the Bible. That's the image to the beast. The beast is the sun god. And the circle with the cross around it, that's what that represents, the sun god. The cross is an image to the beast. In the book of Revelation, it said, whosoever worshiped the beast in his image, the same is going to drink of the wine of the wrath of God. So, the commandment also says, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven images. Just as well, it said, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. That's the Ten Commandments. That's not the law. The Sabbath is not under the law, it's under the Ten Commandments. So I would just call and let you know, when are you going to take that image of the sun god down? Because that's what that represents. I know you don't know this because it's not in the Bible. But God revealed things unto his servants. For again, it is written, God will surely do nothing but reveal his secrets unto his servants, the prophets. And I'm not the only prophet that knows this. There's others he sent and gave us that y'all don't know about. So I just want to let you know, I know what that logos, that symbol or image, whatever you have on your video, I know what it represents. The sun god. The Trinity gods are the sun gods. The Trinity gods are the dragon, the beast, and the false prophet.
Stop it. Y'all, this is what you call a full-blooded false prophet. He ain't mixed with nothing. He full-blooded. Now, you all that's watching now, you can see that logo up in the corner of a cross that represents the suffering of Jesus Christ. What he did on our behalf. He died on a cross, on a tree. The writing on it reads, the Church of our Lord Jesus Christ, Mobile, Alabama, Son of God lives. He said that's an image to the beast. Image to the beast, it represents the sun god. He said, he acknowledging it ain't in the Bible. But this is what the Lord showed him. Let me just take about 2 minutes to show. This is he fits every definition of a false prophet.
Amen.
Amen.
You acknowledging what you're saying ain't in the Bible. You said it. Give me Romans 15 and 4. This is sad. Deception is real, y'all. It is very real. Romans 15 and 4. What did Paul say?
For whatsoever things were written aforetime.
Whatever the prophet said.
Were written.
Pensacola prophet.
Whatsoever things were written.
When?
Aforetime.
Why was it written?
Were written for our learning.
That what?
That we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
No, we through patience and comfort of what the false prophet from Pensacola said.
That
we might have hope.
That we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope.
Here's a man come along and tell you it ain't in the Bible, but the Lord showed him that. And we supposed to believe that.
No, sir.
Brother, get a life. It's so sad. Fellas like this. Now, I don't know this guy. He done come here, I don't know, 3 or 4 or 5 times. You know, he pop up in Sunday school sometime and, you know, he called my office one time and said, we devil worship us because we worship on Sunday. And then I come out my office, he's sitting up here on a Sunday. You ain't even faithful to your own false doctrine. Do you understand? So I don't know this guy, but I guarantee you, I done dealt with fellas like this long enough to know. I don't know if he's married or not, but if he is married, I guarantee you, his wife won't even follow him. She won't even pay him no attention. If he's got children, his children won't even follow him. And I don't even know him, but I know fellas like this. They got all the answers, but they don't even have a ministry. Nobody follow them. But they got all the answers for everybody else. And the Lord don't even trust them enough to give them a ministry. I don't know him, but I guarantee you he fits everything I'm saying. Because I deal with these fellas, call my office, they got all the answers. And ain't what's the address to your ministry? Where your church at? His church is sitting home right now watching Ella Murray. That's his ministry. Do you understand? Fellas like this is a joke. Mm-hmm. They are absolute joke. Do you understand? Brother, do me a favor. Lose my number. Lose it. Amen. Please. Next caller, twin. Caller number 12. Next call. Hold a minute. He want to know when we going to take the logo down. If anything, we'll make it bigger. They got it on. They putting them on t-shirts now. Let me know what size you wear. I'll send you one to Pensacola. Next caller. Caller number 12.
Hello, everybody. I just want you to know I'm calling from Maryland, and I really enjoy pastor's teaching. I just enjoy it all the time, and I was looking at it this morning, so I decided to call in and let you know that God bless y'all abundantly. And like I said, we calling from Maryland. Praise God. God bless.
Mother, we thank God for you. I just needed to hear a breath of fresh air. Thank God for you. Appreciate how the word of God is blessing you all there in Maryland. We got quite a bit of saints with us in Maryland, from Maryland that live in Maryland. I was talking with one of them today. We thank God for them there in Maryland. All right, brothers and sisters, that's it for the phone calls for tonight. I want to address another caller. I'm just going to read his question. Brother Jeffrey Drake is his name. This brother's in a wheelchair, and he wanted baptism pretty bad. He got on a bus this past week, and being handicapped, he rode a bus all the way to Atlanta, Georgia. Quite a few hours. I'm not sure exactly how many hours, but he rode the bus to Atlanta, Georgia. He told me that he was going to do it. But he caught the bus to Atlanta, Georgia, and Bishop Bryan and Minister Cook, they baptized him.
So I thank God for that. And I want to thank God for Bishop Bryan and the saints there in Atlanta. The brother caught the bus to Atlanta. But when Bishop them saw his condition and whatnot and dedication on getting there for baptism, they wouldn't let him catch the bus back home. They had someone to take him home. And I thank God for that.
Amen.
I thank God for that. Thank God for Bishop Bryan and the saints. Thank God for looking for y'all for looking out for that brother. We certainly thank God for that. All right. But he called my office and he asked, why did Jesus have to have his hands pierced, wound in his side, crown of thorns on his head? Why did he have to suffer like that? Well, brother, all of that he had to go through for you and I. He went through all that suffering, brother, for you and I, for our sins. As I was teaching last week, brother, he didn't just die for sin, he suffered for sins likewise. Do you understand? He suffered and died. Why did he have to have his hand pierced? That's fulfillment of prophecy. Psalms 22:16. Watch David prophesy. David is going to prophesy, and David's prophecy, Jesus got to come here and fulfill that prophecy. He's got to come here and do it. All right, Psalms, Abrasive chapter 22, and I want to start reading at verse number 16. Psalms 22 and at verse 16, Abrasive, what did it say?
For dogs have compassed me.
Dogs have compassed me.
The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me.
Assembly of the wicked have enclosed me.
They pierced my hands and my feet.
David is prophesying, and David said they pierced my hands and my feet, but David ain't talking about his hands or his feet. David is talking about his seed that will come out of him. He's prophesying concerning Jesus Christ. So when Jesus Christ come here, brother, he got to fulfill that. His hands and his feet got to be pierced. All of this is part of the suffering that Jesus Christ had to go through on our behalf. Isaiah 53 and that verse 5. Isaiah 53 and 5. What did it say, Bracey?
But he was wounded for our transgressions.
Wounded, brother. Wounded. Wounded. Do you understand? He was wounded before he died. All of that is part of the suffering for sin on our behalf. He was what, Bracey?
But he was wounded for our transgressions.
He was wounded for our transgressions.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
He was bruised for our, bruised, wounded. All of that before death. He went through all that before he died for our what, Bracey?
For our iniquity.
That's our sin. Read it, Bracey.
The chastisement of our peace was upon him.
The chastisement, the way we would have peace with God, God laid it upon him. Read it, Bracey.
And with his stripes we are healed.
Because of what he went through. Because of what he went through, we can be saved. Do you understand? We can be healed. Hear me talking now. So, brother, he went, verse 10, 53 and 10. What did it say?
Yet it pleased the Lord to bruise him.
It pleased the Lord to bruise him.
He hath put him to grief.
God put his son to grief. Read it.
When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days.
Read it.
And the pleasure of the Lord shall prosper in his hand.
He made his soul an offering for sin. Read it, Bracey.
He shall see of the travail of his soul.
God will see the travail, the suffering, the anguish that Jesus would go through.
And shall be satisfied.
He allowed him to suffer until God the Father got satisfied. He went through all of that, brother, for you and I. All right? I hope you got it, brother. And we appreciate, man, we thank God for you, brother, the dedication you had on getting baptized. To take a bus all the way to Atlanta. We thank God for you, brother. And again, appreciate Bishop Bryan and the saints for how they looked out for you. All right, let's get some of the overseas writers here. First one is from Africa. And she writes, I'm your member since last year. I have the following questions. When praying for the Holy Spirit, do we ask it from the Father or the Son? Example, Heavenly Father, send the Holy Spirit in Jesus' name. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Or Lord Jesus, send the Holy Spirit. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Please give a finished example
on how to pray for the Holy Spirit. All right, Bracy, give me Luke 11, 11. I want Luke 11, 11. And then St. John 15, 16. But I want Luke 11, 11 first. What did it say, Bracy?
If a son shall ask bread of any of you that is a father.
Listen to this, Africa. If a son shall ask bread of any of you, which is a father.
Will he give him a stone?
Will you give your son a stone?
Or if he ask a fish, will he for a fish give him a serpent?
Will you give a serpent to your son who's asking for a fish?
Or if he shall ask an egg, will he offer him a scorpion?
You won't do that to your son.
If ye then being evil.
If you being evil, read it.
Know how to good give good gifts unto your children.
If you being evil, evil by nature, know how to give good gifts to your children.
How much more shall your heavenly father.
Who?
Your heavenly father.
Do what?
Give the Holy Spirit to them that ask him.
How much more shall your heavenly father give what, Bracy?
The Holy Spirit to them that ask him.
So you asking your heavenly father for the Holy Spirit, but how are we going to ask him? Give me St. John 15 and at verse 16. What did it say, Bracy?
Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
I have chosen you.
And ordained you.
And ordained you.
That ye should go and bring forth fruit.
This is the Son of God talking. What did he say?
And that your fruit should remain.
Read it, Bracy.
That whatsoever ye shall ask of the Father.
Listen to this. Listen to this, Africa. Whatever you shall ask of who?
Of the Father.
Of who?
Of the Father.
How must we do it?
In my name.
You got to ask in his name. You must ask, Africa, whatever you ask in the Father, you must ask in the name of his Son, which is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
You got to ask in his name. Read it, Bracy, again.
Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
Read it.
And ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit.
Read it.
And that your fruit should remain.
Read it.
That whatsoever you shall ask of the Father in my name.
Whatever you ask of the Father in my name.
He may give it you.
But you got to ask, he said, in my name.
Amen.
Because he's our access.
That's right.
Hallelujah to God. My God, so you got to ask Africa in his name. Give me Colossians 3:17, son. Colossians chapter 3 and at verse number 17. In all thy getting, get an understanding. Africa, we appreciate y'all watching and listening over there. Colossians chapter 3, Bracy, and at verse 17, the Apostle Paul going to let us know whatever we do.
In word or deed.
Whatever, Africa, you do in word or in deed.
Do all in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Do all how?
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
That name again. Who is the Lord Jesus? That's the Son of the Father. That's the Son of the Father. Do you understand? Do all how, Bracy?
In the name of the Lord Jesus.
Hold that, Bracy. Second epistle of John, verse 3. For anybody who want to argue with me, and said, the Lord Jesus is God the Father. The Lord Jesus is not God the Father. The Bible said, 2nd Epistle of John, verse 3 said what?
Grace be with you, mercy and peace.
Grace be with you who?
Mercy and peace.
From who?
From God the Father.
From who?
From God the Father.
And
from the Lord Jesus Christ.
From the Lord who?
Jesus Christ.
From the Lord who?
Jesus Christ.
The Lord Jesus Christ is not God the Father. The Lord Jesus Christ is who, Bracy?
The Son of the Father.
The Lord Jesus Christ is the Son of the Father. The Lord Jesus, do y'all believe the Bible?
Amen.
Do y'all believe the Bible? Come on, apostolics. Y'all carry that Bible. You said, preach the word. Preach the word. Stay with the word. Verse 3 again, Bracy. Is this the word?
Amen.
What the word say, Bracy?
Grace be with you, mercy and peace from God the Father. And from the Lord Jesus Christ.
So from God the Father and from the Lord Jesus Christ. Who is the Lord Jesus Christ?
The Son of the Father.
He the Son of the Father. Go back to Colossians 3 and that verse 17, son. What did it say, Bracy?
And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Do all in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Giving thanks to God and the Father.
Giving thanks to God and the Father.
By him.
By him. You got to come, Africa, by him.
Amen.
Next question. She asks, we don't have a church to attend due to these doctrines, so we just listen to your broadcast every Wednesday and Sunday. How do we partake in the Holy Communion? Africa, give it time and the Lord will work it out. Give it time. I don't know of a way to give you communion if we here in the States and you in Africa. Give it time and the Lord will work it out. I trust God to work it out where either y'all can come here or we come there. Just give it time. The Lord will work everything out in time. All right? Thank God for you and stay in touch with us. Okay. Next one is from Jamaica. Okay, he left a message here, but I'm not going to air his message. But I'm going to answer your question, Jamaica. Jamaica asks, can a pastor be a prophet as well as, can a man be a pastor and a prophet? In other words, can a pastor be a pastor that preach and prophesy? Can he be a pastor that preach and prophesy? Jamaica, the answer is yes.
Amen.
It's yes, Jamaica. Now, I heard a lot, brother, of what you left on my machine, but I want to help you, brother. Let Ella Murray help you. Now, I know you mentioned the different gifts and how they're different gifts. Give me Ephesians 4 and then verse 11. Can a pastor be a prophet as well? This is what he asked me. Can a pastor be a prophet as well? Can he preach and prophesy? Ephesians chapter 4 and in verse 11. Listen, Jamaica. What did it say?
And he gave some apostles.
Some apostles.
And some prophets.
Some prophets.
And some evangelists.
I agree. Some prophets. Okay, that's a gift. Some what?
And some evangelists.
And
some pastors and teachers.
All right. So we got different gifts here, Jamaica. We agree on that. No problem. But God can take that same pastor and give him the gift of prophecy and use him to prophesy.
Amen.
He can, brother. Listen, I could show you a pastor that preached as well as prophesied. 1 Timothy 4 and 1, son. 1 Timothy chapter 4, and we're going to start at verse number 1. Watch this pastor here who declared all the care of all the churches was upon him. That's what Paul said. The care of all the churches was upon him. But watch what Paul is going to do here. 1 Timothy 4 and at verse 1, what did he say, Bray said?
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
Paul, the preacher, said the Spirit speaketh expressly.
That in the latter time some shall depart from the faith.
Is he prophesying?
Amen.
So you got the preacher Paul here that pastored many people. He's also now prophesying what's going to happen in the last days. Read it again, Bracy.
Now the Spirit speaketh expressly.
That what?
That in the latter time some shall depart from the faith.
What they're going to be doing?
Giving heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils.
So now the same apostle Paul that pastored many people, he's a preacher, but now he's prophesying what's going to happen in the last days. That's prophecy, brother. God using him to prophesy. Now, you also made mention about a prophetess. And you say you was talking to someone, and apparently they're trying to augur, you know, for a woman prophetess to be able to go into the word of God. Prophesying, brother, listen, a prophetess, she can only be used to prophesy. She cannot be used to preach because God never sent a woman to preach.
Amen.
The prophet or the pastor, God can use him to preach. God can use him likewise to prophesy. That's the pastor. That's the man. That's the preacher that God can use to prophesy. The prophetess, meaning the woman, God can only use her to prophesy. He can't use her to preach because then he'll violate his own word.
Amen.
Hear me talking. She can only prophesy, brother. She can only, she can't go into the word and teach and break down scripture, because then she's out of the will of God. I suffer not a woman to teach, nor use of authority over the man.
Amen.
I hope you got it, Jamaica. We appreciate you. Appreciate your call. Y'all continue to watch in Jamaica. We coming back that way. Just continue to watch, all right? All right. This is from Trinidad. This is Trinidad. Trinidad writes, Ella Murray, God bless. I must admit, I wanted to get baptized with First Church, but I started listening to you. I was moved by your humility. I have learned a lot from both of you. There is a First Church in Trinidad, but I am listening more than ever to you. So I want to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Trinidad, let me say this to you. I'm going to say to you just like I said to Africa concerning communion. Give it time. I trust God to work it out, brother, where either some true brethren, true ministers of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, will rise up there and make themselves known in Trinidad, and we can send you to them, or the Lord work it out where you can come here, or the Lord allow us the time to get there. Just give it time, brother. Give it time. But Elder Murray would not recommend you going to First Church or any other church. Being baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, a church that don't believe in the Son of the living God.
Amen.
If they don't believe in the Son of the living God, they don't believe in the death, burial, and resurrection of the Son of God, they're not qualified to baptize you, brother.
Amen.
Do you understand? How in the world can they baptize you in the name of Jesus Christ when Jesus Christ, that's God's son. And when you go down in water, that's his son's death, that's his son's burial, and that's his son's resurrection. But they don't believe in the son's resurrection. So how can they be qualified to baptize you, brother? Give it some thought. When you're baptized in the name of Jesus Christ, that symbolizes the death, burial, and resurrection of the Son of God. Not God the Father, because God the Father ain't never died. God the Father ain't never been buried. And God the Father ain't never rose from the dead, because he ain't never died.
Amen.
So baptism represents the death, burial, and resurrection of the Son of God. But they don't believe in the Son of God. They don't believe the Son of God rose. They believe the Son of God died, Son of God was buried, but God the Father got up. That ain't in the Bible nowhere, brother. So therefore, they're not qualified to baptize you, brother. They're using the name of Jesus because they say that's God the Father's name. They use Jesus Christ because they say that's God the Father's name. They don't recognize the Son of God. They don't recognize the Son of God. I got a call here last week, you know, from someone thought they was calling First Church. You know, and look, I get those calls often, and I just, you know, let them know that we ain't First Church. We don't deal with First Church. Goodbye, appreciate you, you know, unless they start asking me questions. When they started asking me questions last week, the brother said to me, I said, we don't deal with First Church, we're not affiliated with Gino, that's, you know, that's not who we are, brother, wrong church. He said, well, wait a minute. He said, wait a minute. He said, so I called there, he said, and this, he said, well, maybe this is divinely inspired. He said, because we supposed to be going such and such a place to meet them. He said, he started asking me questions. And after he started asking me questions, I started answering. And he said, you know what? I saw that too. And look, when I started answering his questions, it was basically confirmation of what he had already saw himself, but was just overlooking it. Do you understand? So, brother, how can they be qualified to baptize? And when they don't even believe in the one that the baptism represents. Romans 6:3, son, we coming to a close. Romans 6 and that verse 3. Let me show you who it represents, who baptism in the name of Jesus Christ represents, brother. Romans 6:3. What did it say?
Know ye not that so many of us as were baptized into Jesus Christ.
Into who, Bryce?
Into Jesus Christ.
So many of us as was baptized into Jesus Christ.
Were baptized into his death.
His death?
His death.
Have the Father ever died?
No, sir.
The Bible said we were baptized into his death. So we was baptized into the death of the one that died. That's the Son of God. Read it, Bracey.
Therefore, we are buried with him by baptism.
Oh, buried with him?
With him.
So we're buried with the one that died by baptism. But what else, Bracey?
Into death.
Into death.
That like as Christ was raised up from the dead.
Oh, Christ was raised from the dead?
By the glory of the Father.
Christ was raised from the dead? God the Father ain't never died.
Amen.
So Christ got to be the Son of God because the Son of God is the one that died. And the Bible said as Christ was raised from the dead, how?
By the glory of the Father.
What did it say?
Even so we also.
Even we also.
Should walk in newness of life.
When we come up out the water, just like Christ was raised by the glory of the Father, when we come out of the water, we walk in newness of life.
Amen.
That's what baptism represents. Death, burial, resurrection of God's Son. Mm-hmm. They don't believe that. If they don't believe that, they're not qualified to baptize you.
Amen.
Let God be true.
Yes, sir.
And every man be a liar. Saints, we thank God for you all. Appreciate all of you all watching around the world tonight. We're going to close it out tonight. Lord willing, we'll be back with you on Sunday. New York, New York. We're looking forward to being there with you all on next week. We're looking forward to it. Let me say this to New York. I have been asked concerning a Q&A in New York. There will be no Q&A in New York. Time just will not allow. But what I will do at the close of service, on Saturday night at the close of service, I will allow you to ask questions. At the close of service, let me make this plain. At the close of service, I will allow you to ask questions. We will go in the Bible and give you a Bible answer. Elder Murray didn't say at the close of service, he's debating with a false prophet. Listen, I won't waste my time debating with no false prophet. I don't have to. I show you chapter and verse and I keep it moving. So don't misunderstand what I'm saying. At the close of service, I will open the floor. Sincere brothers, sincere sisters that need understanding, we will take your questions at the close of service. But for as mean opening up the floor for a debate with some false prophet, false brother, that ain't Ella Murray. Do you understand? Wrong preacher. Hear me talking now. That's not who I am, brother. We show you chapter and verse and keep it moving. All right? So to the sincere brothers and sisters at the close of service in New York, Saturday night, we'll open the floor. We'll allow you to ask some questions. All right? We thank God for you. We love all of you all. And Lord willing, until Sunday, God bless you and peace be unto you.